Anubhutavishayaasampramoshahsmritih. Anubhuta.
Anubhuta.
Vishaya.
Vishaya.
Asampramoshah.
Asampramoshah.
Smritih.
Smritih.
Anubhuta. Anubhava means experience. Anubhuta, experienced. Vishaya, objects. Asampramosha, not losing them. Sampramosha is actually being robbed. Mush, the verb root mush in Sanskrit, mushnati means to rob. Asampramosha. We should not allow our experience to be robbed. That is, we should not lose it. We have many experiences. While walking on the street, we see many cars, we see many people, but afterwards we do not remember them. Some cars were going, we say, which car was coming, unless some special event happens there on account of that car, we do not remember it. Because many things come to the mind, all of them are not recorded. Those that are recorded are not lost. Those things we can recollect. Our friends, most important friends, even though we had seen them 15 years ago, 16 years ago, even 60 years ago, if we had considered them as most important, then even after such a long time, we remember them, we recollect them, because it has been recorded so well, so strongly in the mind. We have not lost it. Many other things, millions of things, we have lost. We don't care about them, and so they are forgotten. And so the things which are known and kept in the mind without losing them, that faculty is called smriti. Only on account of that ability, man has been able to achieve all this progress. See, there are so many other species of life on the earth. There are honeybees. They are actually very intelligent. They have great faculties. From the hive, they go towards a tree which has good flowers, which has nectar in them. They go and collect it and bring it directly back to the hive. They restore it, they build all these things they do, no doubt. But they have not progressed. Just as the bees were doing 1000 years ago, the same thing they do even now. In their technique, no progress. But in the case of man, probably 30 years ago, nobody knew about the mobile. We were going to the phone, and from the phone, nobody we were talking. But now, it is very hard to find any person who does not own a mobile. So these progresses are taking place. We are not building the houses as we were building them 500 years ago. Now the technique is totally different. This progress is there on account of smriti. For a yogi, it is very important. Otherwise, he would be in class 1 throughout his life. If he cannot remember what he learned yesterday, how can you go to the next class? And so smriti is one of the most important functions of the mind. So these are the 5 vrittis of the mind. And so chitta vritti nirodha is yoga. It is so simple. But the problem is how to control these vrittis. Even sitting here in the class, the mind of somebody is imagining many things. Vikalpa is happening. somebody is remembering, you know, when I left New York, you know, I told him like that, I did not know. These days somebody, smriti will be taking place. All these activities of the mind, functions of the mind are continuously happening. Every moment, without exception. And you are telling, control them. How to control it? It is very easy to say, a tornado is coming. Go and control it. Go and stop it. Are you mad? See, this is something beyond our ability. Like that, the mind is also compared to a storm. When a storm is coming, I cannot go and stop it. It is very easy to say, just control all the vrittis of your mind and you will become a yogi when you have yoga. How to control it? That is the main problem. And therefore, taking up that problem, Patanjali is